Hey guys, I'm Meg. If you are new to the channel, welcome. If you are a returning subscriber, welcome back. And it has been a while since I have done a get ready with me video, so I thought maybe this would be the best time to do that. And if you want to see how I created this dewy, colorful look that you're seeing, then keep watching. Right, so we're gonna start. I've already primed my eyelids with these Smashbox. The NARS Pro Prime Smudge Proof Eyeshadow Base, and I have also primed my face with The Ordinary's High Adherence Silicone Primer to fill in my large pores, because you know I've got them. And I've got L'Occitane Lip Balm on my lips to keep that supple while I'm applying my makeup. And also some tape on the side because I need it. Anyway, I have a specific eyeshadow combo that I have in mind that I want to try, and I know it's going to be a little bit messy, so I probably shouldn't have primed my face just yet because that's just going to stick on there. But anyways, it is what it is. So I'm going to be using this gorgeous blue here. I don't know if you can see how beautiful that blue is. It doesn't actually appear very blue on camera, but it is. If you have seen that KKW palette that's coming out in collaboration with Mario, or the Patrick Star, what's it called? Miso Fleek quad that had a blue in it. That's very similar to this kind of blue. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take my Real Techniques shadow brush, and I'm going to take that onto here. And I purposely didn't put on any transition shades on my lids because it's just pigment just sticks a little bit better to it without the transition shade, and that's what I want. I want this to go oomph boom. So I'm just gonna go ahead and foil that with Urban Decay. And I'm going to use the mirror with this. I'm not used to using the mirror that comes in the palettes, but we'll try it. And just see how beautiful that blue is. Now, usually this actually has a lot of fallout, so I wouldn't be surprised if I get... I already have them on this side. I don't know if you can see it. Yeah, but that's okay. Look how beautiful it is when it is foiled. Dang. So I'm putting that all over the lid, and I'll do one lid for now just to show you what I am thinking about. Now I'm gonna go in with this Makeup Forever eyeshadow. This is ME910 from their Artist Shadow Palette number 2. And I'm going to just use my Delium Tool 776. Let's see how this is going to pick up. This is actually a metallic shade, but it doesn't appear very metallic on the lids. There is a little bit of sheen to it, but it's not that deep. Wow, I am liking that. And I'm liking the color that comes out when it gets mixed with that blue. I don't know if you can see that, but look at that pigmentation. Holy crap. Okay, I'm gonna bring that a little bit lower into the crease so that the blue and the pink would come together and create that beautiful purple. Yas, this is what I'm talking about. Okay, nicely transitioned. I'm gonna now get one of my Real Techniques, what is this called? Detailer brush, right there, the teeny tiny tipped ones. Let's see, it's still following my face. Anyways, I'm gonna go back to my Makeup Forever 15 Artist Shadow Palette. Now, unfortunately, this is limited edition from a couple of years back, but you can certainly find similar shades to it. By the way, the shade that I used in the beginning is ME216, and now I am using S102, which is a black. It's supposed to be a satin, but it comes off quite matte as well. And I'm just going to take that at the outer corner, sort of deepen that blue shade there with a little bit of that black. As you can see, it probably looks a little bit like winged eyeliner, which is not my intention, but it came out like that, so let's just leave it as is. Okay, I'm gonna take that black at the lower lash line as well. And then top it off with that blue that we used earlier, because why not? And then I'm gonna take another small smudge brush here, and I'm gonna take that pink that we used in the crease and bring that in there. And help that transition through like that. Okay, now I'm gonna do the same thing on the opposite eye so that it'll be equal. And then I'll do my eyebrows and finish the rest of the face, okay? Okay, so what else I've done for the eyes, I've put on some mascara. I actually just used the Estee Lauder Black Primer Mascara, I think is what it is. Because, well, I've used it so much that everything has just rubbed off of the packaging. That's all you can see now. I also have my Daiso lashes, which I used with the Revlon Precision Clear adhesive. So that's what you're seeing on my eyes at the moment. I've also done my eyebrows, and I used the Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow Pomade in dark brown. So that's it. And I've put on my foundation, and this is the MAC Studio Fix Fluid SPF 15. In NC35, which I only place in the center of my face. I didn't really put it anywhere else so that it blends better on the skin. And I found as well that this is just like makeup for filming. Usually in my everyday, I prefer very, very low coverage foundations. A lot of the times it's only CC cream that I put on my face. Anyway, let's proceed. So I've got my Becca collaboration with Chrissy Teigen right here. I'm gonna be using the bronzer in this palette to bronze up my face, and I'm using the Delum 990 brush, and I'm just gonna put that like how I would use a contour shade, but this just is a little bit more flattering on my skin tone and looks like more natural compared to the eye that I've got on. Right, okay, so I'm just placing that on my hollows of my cheeks. I'm gonna take a little bit of that and pinch my brush and place that on the sides of my nose to create a little bit more dimension in that area. Oop, here, take a little bit of that on the forehead as well. So that's what you do with bronzers, right? So you've got a little bit more color now. I'm gonna go in with this shade here, which is Beach Nectar, which is limited to this palette. I hear she's coming out with another product with Becca, and I'm excited about that because I really like this one. I'm bring this up a little bit up there at the temple. And it's just a gorgeous sort of a natural highlight for those of us with medium to deeper skin tone. I'm sure this is gonna appear a little bit more vibrant for those with deeper skin tones, but on me it just looks like a natural highlight. I'm gonna bring a little bit of that on the bridge of my nose. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to mix Beach Nectar with the blush that's in here, which is called Malibu's. Oh no, sorry, it's Hibiscus Bloom. So I'm gonna dip my Real Techniques blush brush in both, and I am going to put that all over my cheeks because I am digging a shimmery blush lately. In fact, I ordered the Smashbox Vlada highlighter in Rose Mantic, I think is what it's called. And I was not intending to use that, or am not intending to use that as a highlighter, but more of a shimmery blush. I mean, look at that. Just looks like gorgeous skin, doesn't it? So I'm just gonna blend that thoroughly. And then in terms of lips, I don't really know what I want to do with my lips because this is such a striking eye look. I probably will stick to a more nude lip, and this is Truffle by Dose of Colors. Oh, let me just go ahead and apply that. I'm becoming an expert in doing this one-handed kind of thing. Okay. There you go. Look completed. How'd you like that? Kind of edgy, very colorful, but also looks really nice, don't you think? And that's it. Yeah, how do you like that? I'm really digging this eyeshadows. I'm really liking the transition from pink to purple to blue. I'm like, good job, Meg. Good job. So if you like this video, do give me a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and click on that notification bell so that you know when I upload videos. I normally upload about 3 times a week. Usually it's Tuesdays, Thursdays, and I believe it's Sunday. But I know that in the last 2 weeks I've been uploading pretty much every day, so let me know how you feel about that as well. And if you like this makeup, then do leave me a comment down below letting me know that you do like this. And I'm actually thinking that the next Get Ready With Me would have a Q&A embedded in it. So if you have any questions that you want me to answer regarding anything, nothing too personal though, and I'll go ahead and answer that in the next Get Ready With Me. So yeah, leave them in the comment section down below. And as always, I will see you in the next video. Bye!